Relationship Communication. Two manuscripts. Communication in Marriage, Communication in Relationships. Learn to overcome conflicts and slow to anger for a deeper love and intimacy in your relationship. Rina Mcnally. Narrated by Janelle Bigham. Communication in Marriage: The Art of Positive Communication and How to Overcome Conflicts in Relationships and Grow Together. Written by Rina Mcnally. Narrated by Janelle Bigham. Introduction. Communication is the foundation of any good relationship. Strong marriage intimacy may not be possible without effective communication between spouses. Even the marriage that is falling apart can be saved when communication is applied effectively. In the history of marriage, the bad habit of lack of communication contributes to 80% of the problems faced by couples. Negative influences and forces can easily affect the perception of a good marriage when communication is ignored. The importance of effective communication cannot be overemphasized. Mistakes that may destroy your relationship can only be avoided when issues are communicated and when both partners understand each other to a reasonable level. An individual in a committed relationship needs a continuous affirmation that will encourage his or her performance even in the midst of financial struggle. A husband needs to feel appreciated and affirmed for being a good husband and father. He needs to feel that his effort is paying off by actually providing satisfaction and happiness in the family. Since his wife is the most important party in terms of expectations and desires, the affirmation must come from her. This is easily communicated through the providence of assurance and physical affection on a regular basis. Criticism and worry should only be expected when a mistake is made, and forgiveness to follow afterward. Right within the marriage atmosphere, the individual needs to have a safe haven for personal improvement, even as they grow to love their spouses. A wife needs to feel safe and secure. She practically needs her husband to listen and understand her without trying to solve each and every problem. As she pursues a given goal, she needs him as a support system. She needs to have the assurance that she can be herself, be faulty and human, without being criticized all the time. She needs her husband to be able to talk to her with kind words so that she will feel the courage to rise up even when she fails. In general, everyone needs some encouragement from a significant other in order to do better. The better communication works with encouragement instead of criticism. Fairly, every situation that provides an opportunity for criticism can be turned into encouragement. By doing such, you won't only maintain a reasonable intimacy, but you will continue to win your spouse's heart over and over again. The best thing in marriage is when your spouse depends on you for both physical and emotional security. And this only becomes possible through effective communication. Your spouse needs to be validated all the time, so the first baby steps in improving your marriage communication are intent listening and gentleness. Let their positive emotions be aligned to your positive actions and behaviors. You need to be in the position to encourage their potentials, to see their weakness as strengths. Growth, which is very important in terms of long-term relationship, becomes possible. Also, change from a particular phase of understanding to another becomes easier. Reinforcement is not the only benefit of positive words. It is all about selfless appreciation of one's feature, to love and appreciate even when other people ignore. It also entails noticing a less significant characteristic in your partner, and to encourage them to never take what they have for granted. The aim is to influence positively your spouse's approach to life, the marriage, and any other thing that concern them. Chapter 2. Pathways of Effective Communication Within Marriage. Effective marriage communication is the open exchange of beliefs, desires, emotions, feelings, and perceptions. The most destructive element of an intimate relationship is the bad habit of active communication. This brings to life characteristics that despise the standards of a healthy marriage relationship, resorting to selfish or destructive ways of communication, which will, in turn, render one person or both couples unhappy. Communication has to be effective in order to provide positive change and improvement. These pathways of effective communication must be observed in order to improve intimacy and to make your marriage thrive even in the midst of physical or emotional challenges. Emotion. Touch. Spoken communication. Nonverbal communication. Contextual communication. In marriage, words aren't enough when it comes to communicating one's feelings or emotions. The most successful relationship recognizes the different communication pathways and works with them to convey messages and in providing effective responses. The non-confrontational communication. This form of communication is often exercised when there is a misunderstanding or when something is bugging a partner but decides to be silent. The situation might linger for a very long time and may affect the effort of the victim in committing to the entire relationship. Most couples think that being silent about an issue is the safest way avoiding breakup or fight. In my experience as a marriage counselor, passive partners end up depressed because they tend to hide what they really feel and resort to fate in most circumstances. During my sessions with couples, I discovered that most problems, regardless how small, became significant because of the lack of communication on the side of the affected partner. The confronting form of communication. In this case, the partner resorts to shouting and uncontrolled self-expression instantaneously when negativity is perceived. The confrontational communication is the worst type of communication, especially since a person might be shouting for the wrong reason. The partner doesn't need to prove or find out the reason for the other person's actions, so the outburst often leads to regrets and misunderstanding. Often, the receiving partner may be forced to resort to silence or passivity in terms of self-expression in order to avoid the regular outburst. Even when the second person is faulty, it usually requires the composure of the first partner for the issue to be resolved. The discussion communication. This type of communication provides time, space, and balance for both to speak, not in haste, but in accordance with conflict resolution principles. Couples are required to listen attentively to each other as they come to understand the reasons for a particular behavior and resort to a particular change. This type of communication is mostly practiced among older couples, but young couples can employ the strategy in order to make sure that they build a stronger intimacy even from the beginning. They listen attentively to what each other have to say, and they focus on clarifying and acknowledging reasons instead of pushing blames based on circumstances. In this case, feelings and thoughts are easily understood. Couples will have the opportunity to understand each other even better. And the next time something similar occurs in the relationship, they will have the courage to confront the situation, even with greater discernment. Resolving conflict. Couples should know and understand the different methods of conflict resolution and use each method effectively based on the situation at hand. Problems are a constant part of a committed relationship, but what makes the marriage stronger is the resolution method used in every challenging situation. Problems must be intently discussed between partners and resolved to the utmost. No stone should be left unturned when resolving a marriage conflict. The volatile technique. Couples should be able to respect each other and allow for explicit expression of feelings during an upsetting situation. Independence should be actualized, and the sense of individuality should be well reminded. Constructive criticism is allowed even in the marriage relationship, where blame should not be placed, but the realization of fault and a suggestive solution to encourage for improvement. Heated arguments should be avoided by consciously avoiding trigger words, either to be defensive or to push the blame to the other person. Couples should listen to each other with the aim to understand their point of view. The validating technique. This involves the keen method of affirmation directed towards feelings. As a result, couples are able to reach a reasonable level of understanding. Compromise can be made and nobody will feel cheated in the end. Their points of view are actualized based on friendly understanding. These couples should be able to see each other as partners, where collaboration is common and friendship the norm. All selfish aspiration is pushed aside by the value of friendliness in a long-term relationship.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.